What's up, bootstrappers? This is Ryan Nickel coming at you with another day in the life of a real estate bootstrap investor. All right, so episode number 138 coming at you. Overview, how to get a deal in three simple steps. All right, so step one, identify. Step two, find. Step three, contract. It's that easy. Identify, find, contract. So let's go over that in a little bit more detail here. So first off, you have to identify one, who's your target market? For me, it's pre-foreclosures, especially vacant pre-foreclosures, but that's not enough. I need to identify what my target price range is for a pre-foreclosure, because as I have found out from experience, getting a pre-foreclosure is not the end goal. It's getting a pre-foreclosure that is worth something. I've picked up a couple of pre-foreclosures that have just been crap, and I've put a lot of money into them, and I still have not broken even on that investment as of yet. I plan to, it's never my intent not to make money on it. However, identify what your target property looks like. That includes the socioeconomical area where it's at. So for example, my target market is any vacant pre-foreclosure home in the price range between $150,000 all the way up to about $250,000 or $300,000. And the reason for that is that I want a property that has very little repairs needed. I'm not gonna come out of pocket on these properties very much money. Like I have taken over properties or purchased properties that have needed water heaters, new sewer lines, flooring. This one most recently needed a stove and a fridge. All this stuff that I had to, you know, do, put into it. So I'm like, no, I'm not doing that. So for me, my target property, I'm identifying our pre-foreclosures, vacant homes, and that are in the price range between 150 to, let's say, 300,000. That's what I identify. Then I go and I find those properties. I go and I drive those properties, and what I'm looking for is I'm looking for the ones that are vacant. So like I said, I'm finding now. But now finding is not just identifying. So I've already identified the property. Now I gotta find the owner of the property. So I'll drive by, I've identified it, great, it's vacant. Now what I'm doing is I'm now in step two or phase two, and I am finding, I'm actively seeking out the owner. And what I do is I knock on the neighbor's door. I call it the 5-point contact. I am talking to the neighbors on either side and across the street and kitty corner. And I am trying to find out any information I can about that person, where they lived or where they moved to, what their jobs are, anything that's gonna give me some kind of slight edge on this particular property. I'm also gonna go down to the county records. Now I don't have to go down specifically, but if you don't have access to a way to find out who the owner is, in California they don't. They find out, they give you the address of the owner, but they hide the owner, who the owner's name is. But you can do a reverse search, you can look up that person. You can type in the address into Google and it'll tell you who that person is. You can go to True People Search and do a reverse lookup that way as well. Anyway, there are many modes and means for you to be able to find out who that person is. Or just ask the neighbor. Ask the neighbor and then type that person's name into Google and the original or the property address, and you'll see a new address sometimes pop up, or True People Search again. But anyway, I try to find now where that person's at. I jump on social media. I'm looking for phone numbers. I'm calling that person. I'm knocking on doors. I go down and I find that person where they are at, and with the whole intent to get the property under contract. So step one, again, identify the property. I wanna make sure it's vacant, $150,000 to $300,000. Step two, I am now knocking on doors, looking for this person, picking up the phone call, jumping on Facebook, doing everything I can to locate and get in contact with this person. Step number three is to contract. Now I need a contract with this person, but I gotta find out more information. So once I contact them, I ask them, hey, what are your goals with this property? What are your plans with it? I wait for them to tell me, oh, I don't want it anymore, the bank's gonna take it back, or, you know, I haven't really thought much about it, I'm open to ideas or suggestions. So I'm looking at, okay, great, you know what, this person is open to the idea of selling the property. That's something that I want. And so I'll contact him and I'll figure out what's the situation. Is there equity in the property? If there's equity in the property, I'll buy it and I'll flip it. If there's no equity in the property, I'll look at, okay, what are your monthly payments? How far behind are you? And I talk to him just like that. You know, what can I do to help you in this situation here? You're gonna get a foreclosure, you're probably gonna get a deficiency judgment if you've abandoned the property and the property's gone down in value, and they can peg that on you. You're also open up the liability. If this house is still in your name and you know, it's vacant, you know, it's ripe for vandalism, it's ripe for kids, you know, being curious, going inside, getting hurt, something happening, you know, catching fire, whatever, you're on the hook for all that stuff. And so I let them know, like, the seriousness of them just abandoning their property and walking away. And so if it's something that I can go ahead and I can bring current, I'm going to bring it current. And I'm going to, you know, turn it into a rent-to-own situation where I am going to cash flow this thing every single month and carry the paper for whoever's going to buy it from me. So that's what I'm looking to do. And I can't determine which way I'm going to take the contract until I've actually identified the property, found the person, talked to them, understood what their situation is and what mechanics lie behind that as far as the loan and the mortgage and payments and things like that go. And then I go ahead and I get in the contract. If it's way out of whack, way upside down, way, there's no rhyme or reason for me to bring it current and the payments don't make sense as far as, you know, fair market rents go, then I'll go ahead and I'll try to defend the foreclosure on this one. And I have a whole nother strategy for that. But anyway, that's my three-step thing. So anyway, share with me what it is that you are currently doing today. For me, right now, I have identified properties. I am now in the process of finding. I will post my results below here today of what I have found. I have several properties that I need to call on and or do some more research on trying to find out where that person is at. And I will post my results. I want you to post your results down below too, or where you are stuck in this process and where you need help, because this group is a group for action takers. Bootstrappers are people that take action. This is not a group for you just to come and read the posts, watch the videos and do whatever and go, okay, I'm good for the day. That's not what this is intended for. This group is all about action takers. And if you're not about taking action, then you know what? You're more than welcome to stay, but I can tell you, you will not fit in. You will not, you'll always be welcome here, but you might feel uncomfortable because you may be the only one that's not taking action on this particular thing. And look at this, it's getting super dark in here because I'm in my garage and I am home for the day to get my daughter who's having a birthday today. I'm gonna go celebrate that with her. But anyway, I'm gonna pin this to the top. This is gonna be the new top video. And again, post your results. Post where you're stuck. There's no excuse for you not to take action today. I'm Ryan Nickel. Welcome to Bootstrap REI.